Hi guys, today we are going to talk about how do you gain or lose weight. So basically, we know from the previous videos that gaining or losing anything in the body is calculated in calories. So if you're burning calories, if you're burning energy, that energy is calculated in calories. If you're eating food, then the energy from that food is calculated in calories. Kilocalories. Calories and kilocalories are used interchangeably. They are same for the discussion. So, and I have talked about all these things in my previous videos. If you think that you do not know anything that I'm talking about in any current video that you're watching, then go check out my previous videos. They are in a sequence. I talk in a video about things that I've talked about in my previous videos. Okay, so you'll gain weight if you're eating more calories than your body is burning in a day, and you'll lose weight if you're burning if you're eating less calories than your body is burning in a day. That is the answer to gaining and losing weight. That can be for a day, a frame of a day, that can be frame of a week. So let's say you were eating more calories for 5 days a week and then you were eating less calories for 2 days a week. So overall, if you're eating less calories for the whole week, then you will be losing weight for that week. So yeah. So basically, if you're eating more calories than your body is burning, then you're gaining weight. If you're eating less calories than your body is burning, then you're losing weight. Now let's say your body burned 2000 calories today, and by doing all the work, and where the body burns this energy, I've talked about in the previous video, you can go check it out. So if your body burned 2000 calories today and you ate 2800 calories today, then the 800 calories that you ate above the energy or the calories that your body burned are going to give you some weight on your body. So I've talked about this in my previous video. 800 calories is equal to 100 grams of body weight. So if you eat 800 calories more than what you burn, then your body will gain 100 grams of body weight after these calories, after this food that you ate has been digested. So for example, you can say that I had 1 liter of milk and that gave me 800 calories, but when I stand on the weighing scale, my measurement goes up by almost 1 kilogram. That is because you have the milk in your body and it weighs 1 kg, but once it gets digested and you pass the excretion, you pass your waste materials out, then the weight gain on your body, which stays on your body, is going to be 100 grams because you ate 800 more calories than you burned. Now similar is the case with when eating less calories. So for example, you ate your body burned 2000 calories and you ate 1600 calories, so you basically ate 400 less calories than your body burned. So basically 800 calories is 100 grams, so 400 calories is 50 grams, so your body will lose 50 grams of weight after everything is done, after the food is digested. Okay, so now where does this weight gain or weight loss happen? So your body can gain or lose weight on these three sources, mainly on these three sources, actually on these three sources. So fat, glycogen. I'll talk about glycogen in my future videos. So for now, understand that glycogen is stored glucose in your muscles. And third is muscle itself. So your body can gain weight in the form of fat, in the form of muscle, or in the form of glycogen. And your body can also gain weight in the form of water. But water doesn't have any energy. Water does not have any calories. Your body can, at one point of time, your body holds some water. So that water can leave your body, or your body can hold more water without you putting in an effort. So for gaining fat, muscle or glycogen, you might have to put in some effort. So that is calculated as a weight gain. The weight gain from water is also calculated as weight gain, but is not considered in this weight gain because water does not have any calories and the weight that you gained came from calories. So the let's say in the case of weight gain, you ate 800 more calories and now you're going to gain 100 grams of weight. Now that weight, 100 grams of gain can be in terms of fat. Your body can add 100 grams of fat or 100 grams of muscle or 100 grams of glycogen, or it can distribute it. Maybe your body gained 50 grams of muscle, 30 grams of fat, or 20 and 20 grams of glycogen. That way. And similar is the case of weight loss. When you ate less, your body, so let's say you ate 400 calories less. So now after the food is digested, now your body feels okay. I burned 2000 calories today and I got only 1600 calories in the food. Now I need to get the remaining 400 calories from the stored energy in the body. So it can use glycogen or fat or muscle or all of them. So maybe out of that 50 gram, 30 grams is from muscle, 10 grams is from fat, 10 grams is from glycogen. It depends on the case. So this is just to understand that the weight gain or loss can be any of them, can be from any of them. Now knowing that if you eat less, you'll start losing weight. That you just came to know. Does not mean that you start eating less all of a sudden, thinking that you'll lose weight if you eat less calories than you're burning. That is true that you'll lose weight, but that weight loss can be from muscle also, which is very unhealthy. You should not have your weight loss from muscle. I've talked about this in my previous video, crash dieting. So you should not. So there is a pattern when you want to preserve your muscle and lose fat. There's a right way of eating food even when you're eating less amount of food, so that you do not lose muscle. So if you do not know the way, then don't just start eating less food knowing that if you eat less food you will lose weight. I'll talk about how to make the diet in a way that you preserve the muscle and you only lose fat or glycogen. I'll talk about it in my previous videos, but for now just understand that if you eat less you'll lose weight, don't just start eating less all of a sudden not knowing anything else. Okay, so if you like this video, please like it. If you want to say anything, please say that in the comment box. If you like the channel, please subscribe, and if you want to receive notifications for my future videos, you can turn the notifications on. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.